Hey, what's going on everyone, it's Chaz here bringing a new video on Duel Links, and today we are looking at a Six Samurai deck and going to see how well it can actually do in the KC Cup and this meta. Six Samurai is like one of my favourite archetypes, it always has been, even in the TCG, I've always loved Six Samurai. And it is a very underestimated deck because it can do quite a lot of work and put the fear of God into your opponent. Obviously there is the Slash Dragon combo version, but I've took out the Slash Dragon and just made it completely based on Six Samurai. And the reason is the Great Shogun can help versus the Mask decks because your opponent can only activate one spell per trap each turn. That means on their turn and on your turn. So it can stop like quick play spells. So if they activate an enemy controller, they can't activate any other spell. Or if they activate Mask Change, you can't like combo Mask Change with it and stuff like that. I am sitting at a pretty nice rank right now, but we'll see how it goes after when I do a couple of duels with this deck. I'm at 7,222. We will jump in some duels right now with our Six Samurais and see how well we can do with them. I think they can do well. I haven't tested Six Sam right now in the meta, but I think the Slash Dragon variant might be better. I'll just have to test it out and see how it does. As you can see, I have took the Archer dude out, even though he's like a main staple in most of the Six Samurai decks. It's because most of the face downs that you are going to go against is going to only be like D-Wrath or Ultimate Provenance, and you basically don't want to try and destroy that with your Archer dude because your monster's just going to get blown back. So I've took him out completely, and we do have the Cosmic Cyclones to get rid of back row if needed to. So we have opened up with a pretty strong hand, I'm guessing. We'll see what we can do against our opponent. He is running Archfiends, which is pretty bad for us. This is really bad for us. He has such a strong opening right now. We just need to pray he doesn't draw into an Archfiend, because he most likely does have a Call of the Archfiend on his back row. So we'll set down Powerful Rebirth. We'll set down the wall as well. And I think this turn we'll just bring out this guy and try and attack over him. Actually, no, we can't attack over him just yet. So I'll just end my turn. See how it goes. My opponent probably does have Call of the Archfiend set. And if he draws into an Archfiend, we're probably going to see it get activated. He didn't draw into Call of the Archfiend, but he's still probably... Is he going to activate it by banishing one of his monsters? That means he probably has the... trap card where you can target your banished dark types and special summon it. We'll see what he targets. He does target our monster. That's alright because we have Powerful Rebirth. We'll see what he does from this. He is going to go in for battle. I'll Wall of D this. We'll see what he does from that. I'll take the 300 damage as well. There's a zero attack going in for some reason. Does he have the trap face down? He does not have the trap, so we are in pretty good shape. We keep drawing into all of our monsters, which is super unfortunate. You never really want to do that with any deck. Just keep drawing monsters. You want to draw a healthy balance. And them two face downs are pretty scary. So we will bring out this guy, and we'll bring out Hand as well this turn. Just super unfortunate we're just drawing into our monsters. As you can tell on the side of the screen from our deck list, we are running a good amount of monsters and spell and traps. Let's see what our opponent plays. He does let the first attack go through. Will he let the second attack go through? There's Archfiend's Roar. If this was the yellow one, it would have been a lot better because it'll instantly destroy his monster. And his monster is destroyed on his end turn. So that means his other face down is going to be the Call of the Archfiend. Hopefully he doesn't draw into a monster. Let's see what happens. Yeah, he just surrendered. He must have flopped. Because that would have been Call of the Archfiend. If he drew into a monster, he would have been able to resurrect and pop off. So that went pretty well for us. We did draw into a few monsters. Like, too many monsters. If we can open up with a better hand next time, we'll probably be in a better shape. Error? What the hell? Server error? What? What do you mean? I hope that counted. That was a pretty good win. I can throw open a pack as well on screen. in a second. I'll probably do that after. We'll jump into another duel. Please say that counted. Oh, it did count. It did go through. So we'll jump into another duel. See what we can do. I think we'll be able to pop off again. I'm not too sure if I like the balance of this deck yet, or if I should just be running one Great Shogun. We'll see what happens. I might remove one Great Shogun and add one Bow Dude. I cannot remember his name, but it's the guy that destroys a face down spell if you control more than one 6-and-rend monster. So we are going against our next opponent, Aster Phoenix. We'll probably see some Destiny Heroes right now. So if we get Shogun out as fast as possible, we should be in good shape. But for that to open, what happened? We have to open with a pretty balanced hand. He does have the extra deck as well. This is not a balanced hand whatsoever. So the best thing we can draw it into is probably a Powerful Rebirth or our Wall of D. But we're going to draw into more monsters. This deck just loves giving us monsters right now. So I will activate our Cosmic Cyclone just to destroy his back row. Because if he's playing no monsters and he sets one card, it must be something. Yeah. So super unfortunate if our opponent is running his field spell, because now he will be able to attack over our monster. Because his field spell will give his monsters an extra 1000 attack. Let's just hope he doesn't have Drill Dark. Dark will probably screw us the most. So there's the Destiny Calling. Does the Drill Dark as well. He sets a card. He doesn't have the Drill Dark, so we're in pretty good shape. We will take 1000 from this. And if he does have the mass change, it's basically game over. There's a mass change. For some reason, he went into the mass change now. He could have got the attack off and then gone into a mass change, but apparently he wanted to do that instead. He's got a prismatic one as well. That's pretty cool. So it's still game over. But what he could have done is attacked with his monster. We would have took 1000, then mass changed off that. It's just super unfortunate that we just bricked with so many monsters in our hand. This is where I'm on about where I might take out one monster. Even though we're running 2, 4, 6, 8. We're running 12 monsters in a 20 card deck. No, we're running 10 monsters. Yeah. We keep drawing more monsters and spells and traps. So that's an unfortunate loss. I'm going to actually swap around some back row just to see if we can actually make a difference with our draws. For example, I'm going to drop one of the Shoguns, I think. Yeah, I'll drop one of them. Related cards. And then I'll add one of the Bow Dude. There he is. No, I don't want to add two. I just wanted to add the one. Actually, two. I dropped both of my Shoguns. I actually want to run one. And drop one of these. We haven't seen one enemy controller yet, or the Copycat Knight. The reason why I'm thinking six Sams can work so well is because people underestimate him quite a lot. And in the last KC Cup, the third best duelist in the world, if you look in the last KC Cup's dueling thing, was using a six samurai deck, and it caught everyone off by, well, it just caught everyone off. Because as soon as I saw that, I'm like, that is a god. Everyone else is using meta stuff, and he used six samurais to climb that high. And that just makes me think maybe six samurais can still be good. And if it's still an underestimated deck, it's just finding the right flow with the deck. Field of the Warriors might not even be the right skill. You might want to run Restart with it. That way you can keep your six samurais alive for longer and stuff like that. We'll see. I will bring back six samurais to the channel and try it with like different skills and stuff like that. But we do have a pretty solid hand, I guess. So he sets two, ends his turn. We keep drawing Hand of the Six Sam no matter what. I will set Powerful. Actually, I should have activated Cosmic Cyclone before setting the card, but we'll see what we can do. We'll hit that card. It was an Econ. We'll see if we can hit him for 1,800. Will the attack go through? It does. So that Econ tells us nothing about what our opponent's doing. We'll just see. Yeah, we'll just have to wait and see what comes from it. Also, he is actually running Sylvans. He mills the top two cards, and let's see what he hits. He hits a tree. I'm okay with that, and he can destroy a back row. I'm fine with that as well. Obviously, he's most likely going to target my Powerful Rebirth. There we go. But you can't attack over our monster right now, so we're still in good shape. Unless he has another controller. Enemy control is the only other thing they could do. We'll see what he does, though. So right now he's using his trees ability. There we go. He changed the top cards. And he's most likely going to end his turn, unless he does have that enemy controller. We'll see, though. I don't think he will be running a super rush. And his face down is going to be a Powerful Rebirth. No, his face down is going to be a Divine Wrath. Ooh, so this is a solid hand for us. So now we can get Send You out, and we can special summon Sheehan from our hand, and that's most likely game over. So we'll attack and end my opponent's life. There's no way they could come back from that. Sylvan decks, it always comes down to luck, like RNG. What do you have on your top of your deck? What are you going to mill? So it's like not skill based whatsoever. It all comes down to luck. So that was a good duel, I guess. We'll jump into another one. We're almost up to freaking 9,000 already, which is pretty cool, I guess. I did miss yesterday, and I didn't upload yesterday, which I apologize for. I was ill, which sucked. I had like a bug. It was horrible. But I'm back today, showcasing some six arms for you guys. We'll see what we'll go against next. The whole point of six arms, I guess, is this is a YouTuber. D1, this is a YouTuber. So he's probably streaming right now. Shout out to this D1 Green Eyes. Let's see if he can beat him. He's probably recording on his end right now as well. Oh, we just bricked so badly. That's super unfortunate. Hopefully we can draw into a six samurai monster. But it looks like my opponent's going to be running Destiny Heroes himself. If we don't draw into one, like, normal, well, basic six samurai monster, I think it's game over. But I got a strong feeling we're going to draw into a trap. I have no idea why, but I can feel a trap coming. We face a fellow YouTuber who I know, and he knows me, and I brick completely. This is super unfortunate. So now he's going to banish his vision from the graveyard to add a poly from his deck to his hand. And it looks like he's running... Maybe he's got Masked Heroes in there as well. We'll have to find out. But at the moment, it just looks like fusions. He's opened up with a super solid hand for his deck. And unfortunate for us, we bricked. So what I'm going to actually do is run Restart. I really want to try Restart Ninjas. No, Restart Six Samurai, see how they do. So he sets three, ends his turn. We are in a very bad situation right now because next turn he will be able to put that card onto the field and then activate and draw two off. So I'm gonna try and hit one of his back row right now. Watch that be the mass change, and then he mass changes right now. So it's a forbidden choice. I'm okay with that. If we can keep our monster on the field for one turn and draw into another monster, we can bring out Sheehan, and then we'll probably be in a better situation. We'll see what we can do though from it. So he does have something activatable. We will throw these two down. Hopefully he doesn't hatrenade us. And we'll just end our turn. Next turn, if we draw into a monster, we could be in good shape. We'll see what happens right now. It all comes down to what my opponent does. If he fills all three of his spots up with monsters, we're going to be in a bad shape. So there's two monsters on the field. Let's see what happens. There we go, and now he'll be able to activate his monster from the graveyard to draw two cards, I think. No, he can't because he only has one Destiny Hero in the grave. Unless he mask changes now just to get the effect off, but I don't think he's going to do that. There's the Econ. He's going to attribute take. Okay. Oh, that way he can get that. I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. That way he can banish to draw two. That was a good play from my opponent. But we are in a very strong situation if we draw into any six Samurai monster next turn. We're in a very strong situation. We'll just see what happens. We can win this. Let's see what he drew into. I don't think he drew into a mask change of any... I'm actually going to Econ this attack. Because then we could see the mask change off this. The only attack I'll let go through is my Six Samurai attack. Unless he has two mask changes, then we're kind of screwed. But if he doesn't have the two mask change, we're in a very good situation. So I'll let this attack go through. Then we'll see what happens. Yeah, there's the mask change. Hopefully he doesn't have another one in the hand. So out comes his fusion. 3,000 attack. Let's pray he doesn't have that other mask change. So we can throw this into defense mode. If we draw into a six samurai monster, we are set. Oh, he has the third mask change. I mean, the second mask change. That's super unfortunate. GG to my opponent. He literally opened up with the nuts and we bricked so hard. So there it is. So we've won every duel except the mask deck, which is fair, I guess. We can beat Sylvans and random loaner decks and stuff. So right now, I'm actually going to swap the deck over to balance and see how it does. Because right now what I'm seeing is it's not all about like having the greatest attack, it's about opening up the strongest and holding down the board for as long as possible to go for the big plays. So I'm actually going to copy the deck live here and swap it to someone with... Right, so copy my ninja deck. I keep calling it ninja even though it's six samurais. So I'll copy the deck. Then I'll put it on someone with balance, Yugimoto. I'll overwrite this deck because I've got mask decks all over the place. And we'll try one more duel with restart and see how it does. I think I could actually do better with restart. Because that 200 attack boost is nice, but if we can keep our monsters on the field to get the Shogun out, I guess we'll be in a stronger situation. Plus, if we can have multiple six samurais on the field, it's going to be even better for us. I know for a fact this deck can deal with masks, it's just really hard to open with the right hand for it. But with restart, hopefully we can do it. So I think we're facing Hazes right now. I have no idea how this deck's going to do against Hazes, but the Wall of D will probably help quite a lot in the match. We'll just have to see. So right now, this is when restart it comes in clutch, because that hand is awful for us. For some reason, Hand of the Six Sam just always ends in my hand all the time. Exactly. Look at that. It's in my hand at all times. So I'm going to put Powerful Rebirth in the middle, because they usually lock down the middle one first, so we can keep our enemy controller safe there. And we'll see what our opponent is running. It could be Sylvans. I see a lot of Settles running Sylvans. It's either Sylvans or Hazy. We'll just have to wait and find out. So he sets a back card, so... And yeah, there's Sylvans. Let's just completely destroy his life. Actually, no, because it's going to be a Powerful Rebirth. Actually, no, it's not going to matter. It's Divine Punishment or whatever it's called. Actually, is it a Floodgate? It was activatable right there, so... We'll see. I'll tribute that monster off to destroy his face down. So it's not a Divine Wrath or anything. It's probably an Econ. Ooh, so we are facing a Hazy deck. That enemy controller is not going to come in handy whatsoever right now then. So we really do need to draw into that powerful Rebirth. What sucks is... actually, no, it doesn't. I could get both of our monsters up to 2,000 attack this turn to kill my opponent. Creature swap. That's going to be 1,800 attack as well. Not creature swap. Swamp mirror. So he's going to pop off on us next turn. I could Econ take, but we can't powerful rebirth because we set it this turn, so it's not going to be enough damage to kill him anyway. So what I'm going to do, end my turn. On his draw phase, draw your card. I will activate Econ. Econ tribute. What, I can't take control of one of his monsters? Oh, that's bad for us. What, does it say that I can't tribute? This is also classed as a trap. I thought what I was going to do is Econ take it so he can't tribute. And then obviously our powerful rebirth monster back so he couldn't lock down anything. And then we would have been set for next turn, but that's super unfortunate. I guess this is a lost duel. Yep. And then from that he's going to bring out two giant monsters. There's literally nothing we can do right now. So that's a feels bad man. So I'm just going to surrender there, because he's going to take quite a long time to pull out two monsters and do all of his crazy stuff only to end us. We know how that duel is going to end anyway. But hey, we won a few, we lost a few. The main like deck we lost against was Mask, but Mask is a super powerful deck. I have the deck myself. It's a very valuable deck. But yeah, so Six Samurais, what I'm going to do is test them more, see what else I can do, test them with, yeah. Basically, just keep using them, seeing how powerful I can get. Maybe go back to the Slash Dragon variant, see if the Slash Dragon variant's going to be better for us, and bring back the deck another time. So hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like. It really helps our channel. Subscribe if you are new, and wait until this pack comes up, see if it's anything cool. Any day now. And... I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.